Hello, dears. It's Professor Knestor, Jackdaws, and I'm coming to you this afternoon from my home here in Oxmouth to say hello and to encourage you, particularly those of you who are creatively minded, you artistic sorts that, settle down to work at your pad of Bristol paper or your Arches watercolour paper and try to render something that might be pleasing to you or to other people. Some remarkable things have happened recently. Those of you who have watched my podcasts, over time probably recognize that I have a great attraction to some of the early artistic movements. I mean early, before the dawn of time, by which I mean, of course, the cave paintings. Now, the cave paintings are a global phenomenon. They are not simply in France, such as Lascaux, or in Spain, Altamira, but they really have been located all over the planet, in Africa, of course, Australia, not just Eurasia, and even in Indonesia, the oldest of cave paintings, they say, and I don't know how they date these things. I guess they can somehow date the stalagmite that drips over the painting and figure out, well, it must be earlier than that stalagmite if it's underneath, which is very sensible. The earliest of those paintings apparently has now been discovered to be in Indonesia. Very remarkable. Anyway, one wonders about these paintings. First of all, it's a mystery what they mean exactly. Various ideas have been put forth about shamanic practices where the hunters would gather in the cave and somehow glean some sort of power or mojo from the walls simply by, inscribing or putting a little bit of a buffalo on the wall or a crocodile or maybe just their hand, to give their hand power as well. This all seems very unlikely to me. I imagine artists of 40,000 years ago, which is the estimate, 35 to 40,000 years ago, doing these cave paintings, were very much like artists today, wanted to create a story of some kind, some sort of an effect that would, that would interest their fellow men and women. I'm sure there was, I'm sure there were women cave painters as well, but they wanted to attract the opposite sex, perhaps, have people over to the cave. We don't know, but we can conjecture that people are pretty much, the same in their basic drives as they are today. And speaking of today, there was apparently something very, very groundbreaking, which of course will just fan the flames of this whole discussion, which is that a translation was finally made of a bit of inscription at the bottom of a very ancient cave painting, not too far from here in Oxmouth, just a few clicks down the road. Anyway, I thought you might be interested to know. And it shows up something that's quite, bears quite a bit of similarity to painters of today. The inscription reads, "Worked hard, cave damp, bison painting me grief gave. Zerg say bison look like bison dung. Hate much Zerg. Hit with rock on head, me want to, but didn't, next time." So, even in that very, very ancient period, we see that there is artistic competition, jealousy, disappointment, and criticism, which unfortunately has carried forth to today. And artistic criticism seems to be the indoor sport of not a few people. And, it continues to be an absolute poison to artists of any practice. And so I'm sure that you will do whatever you can to cut it out of your life, just as I have cut it out of mine. I've never felt better. Now, I don't indulge in criticism, and I don't care to receive it. So, if you'd like to leave a comment below, make sure it's a very complimentary one. We'll all be happier. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Professor Knestor Jackdaws. Ta-ta.